Nästa punkt på listan kommer att vara den världsberömda skolan Polimoda i Florens i Italien. Och de har en liten provföreläsning för oss helt enkelt. Och den kommer hålla på lite längre än de andra föreläsningarna vi har haft. Anledningen till det är naturligtvis att de har så mycket spännande saker som de vill berätta för oss. Så att den här föreläsningen kommer hålla på i en timme. Och vi hoppas att ni tycker det är jättespännande. Får väldigt gärna skriva i chatten om det är någonting ni funderar över. Och annars så finns jag här efteråt också. Men med det sagt så skulle jag vilja lämna ordet över till Fabrice på Polimoda till att börja med. Hi Fabrice, how are you? Oh, sorry.
Fine. Thank you very much. Sorry, my mic was over. Very, very fine. We are here in Polimoda and thank you everybody for being here with us today. So I just want to quickly, briefly introduce you to Nicolò. Nicolò Sbaraglia is a former Polimoda faculty member. He has been teaching for years and years in Polimoda in the business department. And he's also an expert, a professional in the fashion industry, as he has been working for many years in the fashion industry and keeps working in the fashion industry. And today he's here with you to give you some insights about the fashion profession, so the jobs that await you in fashion. So I will now pass him over the mic and have a good presentation.
Okay. Can you hear me? Can you hear me very well? Hi, nice to meet you. This is Nicolò Sbaraglia. I'm a professor of craft to business in Polimoda Fashion Institute and I've been working in the fashion system since 2007 as a product manager. Specifically, I'm producing leather goods like bags, wallet, and belt, and leather jacket for the most important Italian, French, and English fashion brands, specifically for Kering Group, specifically for Gucci, Saint Laurent, and Alexander McQueen. And this is what I teach in Polimoda. Before to show you the presentation, I would like to spend some words about Polimoda. Polimoda is located in Florence, which is the historical and the real fashion capital in Italy before then Milan, since the Renaissance time. We start working in fashion around the 16th century. Polimoda is the first fashion school in Italy and is the fifth most important fashion school in the world. Polimoda is organized with two different departments, the business department and the design department. The head of the design department is one of the most important designers in the world, which is Massimiliano Giornetti. He used to lead the Ferragamo brand for more than 17 years. And all the professors in Polimoda are people like me. They are fashion managers. They teach what they do. So it's very practical school, and Polimoda is the only fashion school located in the production district. Probably you already know that the 95% of the luxury fashion brands are made in Italy, specifically in Florence. So you can find Dior in Florence, Celine, Alexander McQueen, Burberry. They are technically, they have the legal headquarters in Paris or in London, but the production headquarters are in Florence. This is give us the opportunity to bring our students in the factories and in the fashion brands company. They can see the collection even before to be launched in the market. Of course, it is strictly forbidden to take a picture to shoot the video, because obviously this is part of the secret of the company. Polimoda is in partnership with many fashion brands for masters like Gucci for retail management, or Richemont Group, or Ferragamo, for example. So all the professors are managers of top fashion brands. The majority of the professors, they are coming from all over the world. And the Italians are just the minority. The 70% of the students are international. We teach just in English, and we bring our students in the fashion capital. For example, we've been on Stockholm 3 years ago, so we don't teach just the Italian fashion system. We teach the entire fashion system, because we don't want to standardize our students. It's not our goal. We are here teaching and helping students to have their own personal growth. Okay, so this is fundamental. Okay, your identity is the priority. And Polymoda has the biggest fashion library in Europe. This is why fashion brands are constantly coming in Polymoda making research. We have guest lecturer every week, people like the CEO of Gucci, Mr. Marco Bizzarri, or Susie Mankets, which is one of the most important journalists and opinion leader in the fashion system, Renzo Russo, which is the leader and the founder of Diesel. Then another important thing, both undergraduates and master's course, at the end of the course, all the students have the opportunity to have internship programs. We have a business link 2 times per year where the students can have the opportunity to have several interviews. The same amount of the interviews you have actually in 1 year or 2 years, you can have in 3 days. This is another important point. Polymoda has 3 different locations, and I will show you in the video at the end of the presentation. Let me start sharing the presentation with you, because I would love to clarify the most important job profile in the fashion system, especially now that we are under this terrible crisis, no? The coronavirus, which is very peculiar for every one of us. So let me share it. Tell me if you can see it. I hope you can see the presentation. So we will start talking about the design department. So fashion design department, fashion designer. As you know, the designer is the person in charge for the fall, winter, spring, summer collection, is the one that physically is drawing the collection, is getting the inspiration from the trend forecasters, is transforming the inspiration in area, the idea become a sketch, and the sketch is going to be transferred to the product manager like me. When we talk about fashion designer, you have to consider that you can be also accessories designer, costume designer, bespoke tailor, quality control, and textile specialist. Fashion designer is an undergraduate course. It takes 4 years, but we have also the master in fashion designer, which takes 9 months. Then creative director. The creative director is a designer at the top of the career. So the creative director of Gucci is Alessandro Michele, or Ferragamo used to be Massimiliano Giornetti, my colleague. So the creative director is not just a designer, he's also a manager, managing and coordinating a team of designers in the design studios. Creative director is a master, it takes 9 months. Then we have accessories designer, which is an undergraduate course, 3 years. The accessories designer, as you know, the accessories represent the most profitable business for any fashion brands. They make a lot of money, much more with accessories than regular clothing. And so in this course, you will be trained on how to draw accessories. When I'm talking about accessories, I'm referring to leather goods, not just leather goods, but even fashion jewelry, fine jewelry, and shoes. If you attend a course like this, you can become also a quality controller, developer and leather technologist, technical director, product development manager, head of innovation, and freelancer fashion consultant. So remember that the fashion designer are split on regular designer and accessories designers. Then we have fashion technologists. This is one of the most important key job profile in this moment, because it's the person in charge making the model list. So he's traveling a lot around the world, assisting the designer, even in the fashion show, is the one making the last adjustment for the suits, for the model before to enter on the catwalk. He's the one transforming the creativity of the designer on in a finished product, going through model, proto, and sample. Remember that Italy is the only country in this moment producing luxury, so it's not easy to transform an idea in tangible product. These people are crucial and fundamental. Fashion technologist course takes 3 years. is an undergraduate course. And if you read below on the slide, you can see also where to spend this know-how. Pattern maker, textile specialist, materials purchaser. Obviously, they become expert of materials because they know how to transform a product. If you want to use a silk or cotton or leather, so it's gonna help the designer and better develop the collection. Then we have the collection designer. Collection designer is a master. You become designer also in this course, but of course the target for this master is specifically for people they already have a background in design. So let me represent the three different levels. We have a fashion designer, collection designer, and creative designer. Collection designer is different compared to the regular designer because in this case, you develop your own collection. So you're going to put yourself in the collection and you're not going to interpret the input coming from the creative director. So it's kind of different. It's much more self-centered, this course. So you become freelance fashion consultant, accessories designer, costume designer, bespoke tailor, and quality controller and textile specialist. Please feel free to ask me all the questions you want. I'm a big fan of questions and I like when students engage the conversation. So don't be shy, there is no problem. You can interrupt me anytime, okay? Then, under the fashion business department, we can find, these people in the picture are my students. You can find fashion brand manager. Who is the brand manager? Is the person in charge creating, preserving, and reshaping the identity of the brand, is the person which is going to encompass the vision and the mission, okay? The vision is the big goal and the mission is how to reach the vision. So if you're going to be a brand manager of an historical fashion brand, you have to make sure to keep the identity of the brand in the future and has to be consistent. If you are going to be a fashion brand manager for an emerging brand, of course, you have to define the new identity. This is a master, it takes 9 months. Then an undergraduate course, 3 years, marketing manager. This marketing manager is also product related because you cannot be a marketing manager if you don't know anything about product and about production. The marketing manager is gonna be an expert of market. So they study the consumer behavior, they study the competitors, and they target the market to better reach the final clients. So basically, they have to maximize the company visibility. Then in this course, you study, as I told you, also the production side of the fashion system, because when you have to determine the price strategy, for example, of course, you have to keep in mind the production cost. So you have to spend some time in a factory too, to understand how it works, the production. Otherwise, it's just theoretical and blah, blah fashion system, and this is not up to us. Communication manager, it's part of the marketing. Communication manager is a master. It takes 9 months. We teach you how to build the content communication in terms of video, in terms of picture, in terms of articles. So we teach you also how to write a content, a text, and not just online, but also offline. When I'm talking online, I'm talking about social media, website, and e-commerce. But communication managers are heavily involved also in the offline strategy, and offline I'm talking about, for example, fashion magazine or the boutique. So how the distribution, because this is an offline communication, and of course they have to maximize the company's visibility. Job profile: strategic planner, account manager, client director, editor, journalist, freelancer, project manager. Then again, product manager, which is my job. For me, but of course, I'm not unbiased because I'm totally involved. This used to be and is my job. Thanks to this job, I spent 8 years in the United States connecting the American fashion brands to the Italian production system, like Calvin Klein, Ralph Lauren, for example. I love this job because I'm working both close to the designer and in the factories too. And I'm connecting the creativity, which is intangible, to the practical aspect of the production. So I'm an expert of leather, and I know in advance if we can realize a collection with lamb leather or calf leather or fabrics or silk. It depends, obviously. So it's in a very strategic job, and fashion brands are constantly looking for people with these skills because it's hard to find a product manager in a city without a production district, okay? Then, buyer and merchandiser, who is the buyer? Well, it depends, because you can be a buyer of a fashion brands. In this case, if you work for a fashion brands, you become buyer of raw materials in order to realize collection. Or maybe you can be a buyer for department store or boutique. In this case, you become an expert of finished product. Again, the product is fundamental, because if you don't know how to evaluate the quality of the product, you don't know what to buy. So it's fundamental. So we bring product in our class, face to face to our students. We teach to them how to make the quality control, what to watch, the stitching, the artworks, the silk, the interior part of the product, the lining. Then the merchandiser. The merchandiser, it's a fundamental role, okay? The merchandiser is the one projecting the collection. So it's collaborating with the designer. While the designer is drawing the collection, the merchandiser is projecting the collection, is a marketing analyst too, with an high-end skills in product and production. They travel around the world to better interpret the culture of the market. Because of course, if a collection works for Italy, probably doesn't work for China. So the merchandiser in Europe, it's much more product oriented. The merchandiser in the United States is much more marketing oriented, okay? So they study the consumer behavior, they study the competitors, what they do in terms of collection. And they have a good eyes in terms of trend forecast for product, in terms of shapes, colors, and materials. This is a master. It takes 9 months, like all the masters in Polymoda. Then retail manager, this job profile, it's becoming stronger and more important than before, because the e-commerce is close to the collapse. It's very packed. So when you want to sell luxury products, you need to sell it offline. The retail manager are the people driving the client in the boutique to the product. The boutique now more than ever are not just boutique, they represent a journey for clients where they can experience the identity of the brand. And the clients now more than ever want to be covered. You know, they prefer to enter in a small boutique instead to go online, or maybe instead to enter in a big department store. They want to feel part of the family. So strategically talking, the retail manager are the last frontier before then the client. So they represent the brand in front of the clients. Job profile, store manager, sales manager, retail buyer, merchandiser manager, distribution manager, e-commerce manager, visual merchandiser, and license manager. When I'm talking about visual merchandiser, is the aesthetic, is the architect of the boutique. So they are expert also on how to set up the entire boutique, the space, the physical space. Then here, sustainability. Sustainability is taught to every single courses because it's a central point, but we have also a master full dedicated to sustainability, specifically under the production point of view. Let me tell you something that apparently sounds provocative, but is not. For example, in the fashion system, there are a lot of and big stereotypes. The most sustainable product and materials is the leather. The leather in Italy is 100% recycled by the food industry. So we don't kill any animals. We recycle product coming from the food industry and we transform in a finished product. The worst product that you can find in the fashion system is the synthetic fur, because it's plastic and is polluting the environment. Or maybe the eco-ladder, which is just an invention by the communication because it doesn't exist, the eco-ladder. It's plastic spread out on canvas. So sustainability is not just an hashtag for social media. It's something that you have to understand going in the factory and understanding what does it mean. So we talk about traceability, we talk about circular economies, we bring our students in the production district and we show them what does it mean to work in a sustainable district. Sustainability is also expensive, okay? Other job profile, sustainability specialist, circular economy manager, diversity manager, ethical trade manager, sustainable business manager, supply chain director. The supply chain is fundamental because the production side of the fashion system made by fashion brands is an outsourcing. So no one of the top fashion brands in the world are producing in home. Okay, they have a special contract with private factory in order to produce. So this is the supply chain. And in order to study the supply chain, of course, you have to go to a countries where the production system is in place. Art direction is an undergraduate course. It takes 4 years. It's one of the most important job profile now, because the art director is the responsible for the image of the fashion brand. He or she has to transfer the personality of the brand in the image. That director, in this course, you learn how to use camera, how to use the most advanced software, how to make a video. And art director are used a lot also in museum. As you know, many fashion brands have their own museum, like Gucci in Florence here, or Ferragamo here in Florence. And as you know, Ferragamo is also the president of Polimoda, so it's my boss. And or maybe Prada in Milan. Prada has a very beautiful museum. So art director are people involved in exhibition. They become expert also in how to set up in a space. In Polimoda are coming manager from the Uffizi Museum. Probably you already know that Uffizi Museum is the most important museum that we have in Italy. They are coming and they teach in Polimoda how to exhibit, how to make an exhibition. Our director are involved in communication campaign and in fashion magazine. So they work 360 degrees. Do we have a question? Maybe no, maybe not. Okay. Then fashion stylist. Fashion stylist are, don't make mistakes, okay? Stylists are not a designer. Stylists are not drawing any collection. Stylists are making outfit for celebrities. So they edit the collection, they assemble already finished product for celebrities or for fashion magazine. They work as a video makers, as a photographers. They work close to the designer and to art director. Fashion stylist is an undergraduate course, takes 3 years, but we have also a master in fashion stylist. Then let me show you the trend forecaster, which is a master, 9 months master. The trend forecaster are under the social cultural point of view. So they are analysts, they study politics, economics, technology, art, music. In Polimoda, we study psychology and sociology. And they study the past to better interpret the future. So they are the people giving the inspiration to the designers, but not just to the designer, even to the marketing manager, to the communication manager. So they approach the world in a very technical aspect. I constantly work with trend forecaster, because they help us to keep going in interpreting the behavior of the people and the society. Other job profile as a buyer, stylist, editor, critique, and freelancer fashion consultant. Then fashion critique. This is a new job profile. Fashion critique is an independent thinker, so these are part of the theorists of the fashion system. They study the history of the fashion system, but also the contemporary fashion. They become critics, so they have to be very well informed about the history of every single fashion brands. And they become event curator, but even journalist. They are the people they work in museum too. They work close to the designer, marketing manager. They become journalists. And I love this. I mean, honestly, I love my job as a product manager, but if I have to change it, I will become a fashion critique manager, because this is more theoretical, but more related to the contemporary fashion, the history of the fashion system. Fashion curator, fashion theorist and writer, fashion consultant, visual director, brand communicator, fashion editor and fashion activist. These are the other job profile that you can reach attending this course. Now, let me see what time is it. I would love to save sometimes to talk directly with you. So please ask me question, but before then this, let me show you the Polymoda video and that will become, I will back to you.
I would like to talk about Polymoda as a person. It's a person who has empathy, who has vision. It's a person who likes to share knowledge. It's a person that looks into the future, knowing the past. If you look at all those different aspects, I think Polymoda is one of the best schools in the world. We close the gap between education and fashion industry leaders.
More than 2,300 students from 70 different countries, I have classmates from all over the world.
Polymoda has three different campuses in the best areas of Florence. Three campuses with different souls. Three campuses that are very specialized and very unique. From business links to our job placement day, our career office will guide you into the industry.
Florence is the capital of the Italian fashion system, and specifically, Florence is the biggest leather district in the world.
Knowledge without practice is not enough. You learn by doing here.
Addicting, you know, you read one book and you look at the bibliography at the end and then you want to read 10 more books, so it's easy to kind of get lost in the library.
All of our teachers are directly working in the industry and bring their everyday experience to the school.
We don't pretend to save the world, we just do things. And what we do is invent a new way to study, which is a mix between the vision of a big university and the practicality of our vocational school. That is Polymoda. And that's the way here in Bed School.
Okay. Oops. Okay. Here we are. So, do you have any question for me? You want to talk to me? You have some curiosity about job profile, about Polymoda in Florence, or I don't know, maybe about, we have also scholarship in Polymoda. So during the year, we have a several intake for the scholarship. You can get all the information on our website and social media too. Then what I can say more about Polymoda, the class are very small. We don't have more than 20 students each class. I know my student by name, each of them. We bring, we teach, I mean, except for this moment, that of course we have to teach using Zoom and other platform. Usually we teach face-to-face with our students, as I told you. it's really important for us, this aspect. It's part of also of the Italian culture. And we bring product in the class, and we provide with the didactics. So every single professors are preparing the PowerPoint or keynotes, and these are going to be approved by the faculty, by Polymoda. So the program is constantly updated, which is another fundamental aspect. The 92% of our students find a job in less than 6 months, and the rest of the 80% are not even looking for a job because they are already part of the family job, so they are going to be reintegrated on the family business. Okay, Fabrice, I finished with the slides. Let me come back. Any questions?
I have one question, actually, Nicola. So talking back about the, sorry about the echo. Maybe you hear an echo because I'm in this beautiful classroom, but it's very huge. So going back to fashion job profiles, what would you say is the difference between studying fashion today and studying fashion like 20 years ago? I mean, are the profession, the job evolving as fast as the fashion industry, or you mentioned a lot of new jobs like sustainability manager, for example. Those jobs didn't exist like 5 years ago or 10 years ago, or at least it's not that people was not caring about sustainability, maybe much less than today, but still people was already thinking about that. So my question is, how are jobs evolving? Is people able just to study something today and to be able to live from that during all their lives? Or do they need to study continuously new things? And the job that exists today, are they linked to new skills, or it's just the same skills in a new context? It's a lot of questions altogether.
No, it's fine, it makes sense. No, I perfectly understand what you mean. I mean, it's the central point. You have to study for the rest of your life. You have to be updated because the fashion system is go very fast. It's going very fast. It's constantly changing. And you have to give an answer to this. But I think after this pandemic era, everything will change a lot. We will go back to the normality, to the reality. We will slow the fashion system. We will come back just with two collections for winter and spring, summer. No extra collection in between because it doesn't make sense, especially if you want to produce a sustainable product, it takes time. In Italy, in order to produce a sustainable bags, I mean, I'm talking about the entire stock, it takes at least 2 months and a half if you want to have a luxury product, a sustainable product. So fast fashion, it's contradictory to sustainability, and it's a contradiction to many other things under the production point of view. But even the consumer behavior of the people will change a lot because we cannot keep going buying a t-shirt that it costs €3 or $3. Because if the retail price is $3 or €3, it means that the Hoodset's price is €1.5 and the production cost is 70 cents. So it's impossible. It means that it's produced by baby children. You're not going to respect human rights. So sustainability is not just production, it's also how you respect the human rights in some part of the world. Okay. So we have to be very informed, and we don't have to get the information on YouTube or social media, because of course these are manipulated by someone else. So fashion is something complex and important. It's a pleasure, but behind the pleasure, there is a word, a big word. So this is what I suggested to the new generation. Be informed. Don't follow the stereotypes. Make sure about what people, and also about what fashion brands says, because many fashion brands are not honest. They don't say the truth. They build the communication a different way of what they do under the production point of view. they love to spend and to put made in Italy, and sometimes they're not even made in Italy. So it's a, in Polymoda, we have the financial police coming as a teacher to teach to our students the contrafaction, to teach the fake products, you know? So because the new generation has to be informed about what they buy, the consumer behavior will change a lot. A fashion brand has to train clients on a new era. So buy less, buy better. And then even when we talk about luxury, luxury for us is the opposite of vulgarity. It's not necessarily the opposite of poverty. This is a stupid idea that luxury has to be expensive. It depends. Luxury can be expensive if you use expensive raw materials like diamonds on gold, but otherwise I can produce luxury using raffia, which is a very cheap material, or using wood, but maybe is made by artisans. So that is a real idea of luxury, something rare in the market. So especially the new generation has to be training on reality, because fashion system in the past years didn't show what is fashion behind the scene. The best way is to go in an authentic school close to the fashion brands, because sometimes I don't even understand how fashion school can teach fashion using books or using just theoretical programs. It doesn't work like that. I hope I answered to your questions. And this is the difference. When you use professors coming from the fashion industry like we do in Polymoda, there is no space for mistakes. There is no room for theoretical aspect, no, even in the theoretical part of the fashion system. So, dear students, I can see Alex, Eba, Elias, Emma, Ingrid, Tove, or Yub. You want to interact to me? You have a question, some curiosity? Please, ask me. No, they are all shy. They are all... No question? Friday, we had the open day in Polymoda. So you can get all the information on our website. I suggest you to attend it because we will explain you in details every single course, one by one. And it's in a good moment to gather in the information. We can provide also with accommodation, with all the information to come in Italy. And at Polymoda help the students 360 degrees. So it's a community. Other point? Okay, here we have a question from Eban. Is it hard to get acceptance? Do I bread high grader? So, well, Eba, look, obviously, like the rest of the university in the world, we make an exam. And this is going to be done by Skype. Fabrice send you the link to get information about the open day in the meanwhile. So you approach Polymoda and they will answer to you, and they will set up a Skype call with the leading teacher where they will interview you and they will test also the level of the English. And after a 20 minutes conversation, we will get the main information about you. You don't have to be an expert of fashion, of course, because you are attending, you asked to attend Polymoda for this reason, so don't be worried about this. We are not going to ask you questions related to the background in the fashion system, but we want to see the attitude of the student, the level of the English. So we use this Italian approach. We talk to people, we interact to them to better understand who you are, okay? And then after 3 days, we will contact you back and we will let you know the result. How many gets accepted every year? What do you mean gets? How many students? Because we have a limited, Polimoda is a no-profit university. So our goal is not to become bigger than what we already are. So we want to keep the quality high, small class, no more than 20 students, as I told you, maximum 25 in the masters. So of course I have a lot of Swedish students in Polimoda. And honestly, not because I'm in front of you, they are very good. Also because, as you know, there isn't a big tradition in your country under the fashion and the creativity point of view. Interior design, cards, and fashion. I brought my student in Stockholm 3 years ago. We went to see the Stockholm Fashion District, and the leader is half Italian and half Swedish. She's a beautiful lady. She speak fluent Italian, fluent English, and of course your languages. It was an amazing experience. And again, I'm not here telling you how cool you are, but I spend a lot of time in Sweden. I've been basically everywhere, even in Kalmar, not just Stockholm, Gothenburg. And then I've been even in the small highland in front of Kalmar. It's called Holland. For my pronunciation, because it's not, but I've been everywhere. And we get a lot of inspiration from the Swedish fashion system, because you are famous for the minimalism. And it's not easy to produce a minimal product, so a minimal design. So Italians are constantly getting inspiration from the North Europe, and we interpret it this. Ebba, don't worry. You can try to attend, to have an interview with us. And what else? Other questions?
Nicola, I just wanted to, if I can also to answer Ebba. I know that you have been sometimes pushed for years and years to get the best grades and to, you know, to right. Be competitive and to push your limits and always achieve. We totally respect this. But the fact is, Polimoda is a fashion school, and whatever you've done before can be useful to enter a fashion school, including mathematics, including, because this will have shaped your personality. But at the same time, it will not really be useful, whatever you've studied, because you will have any way to learn a new world, to enter a new world. This is why we don't want to give so much importance to grades, because we had the experience in the years of students that were not that good, for example, in high school. It's different with university, but were not that good in high school. And when they came to Polimoda and they started studying what they really loved in the field of fashion, they just turned into geniuses. And they had the best possible grades here. So what we are looking for, what Nicola was saying is, the grades are important to say you dedicated a lot of time to study, you are someone that is concentrated and passionate about what you do. But at the same time, we want to give everyone a possibility based on what really matters. That is your personality, your identity, and who you want to become in the future through us. That's it.
We are not looking for students. We are looking for human beings. That's important. And again, the difference between Polimoda and many other fashion schools, we are not a private company focused on money. We are a no-profit company. We legally talking, we cannot manage money. You understand what I'm saying? It's very important. The goal for Polimoda is the know-how. It's how we teach and how we train the new generation. This is also give us a good, we are trustable in front of fashion brands. That's why fashion brands are collaborating with Polimoda, the French, the Italian, the English, and the Americans one. They come to us because they know the value of the didactics, the content that we teach to them. And also because part of the professor are manager of the fashion brands. So the opportunity for you start from the very beginning, from the first day in the Polimoda school, because your professor can offer the first job. I personally hire 8 students in the past 2 years, and now they work in a caring group, 6 in the caring group and 2 for Fendi, for example. Okay, and this is not just an example to show off to you. It's true. And many of my colleagues are doing the same. So your opportunity, it's very competitive, eh, Polimoda. So you have to come every day. It's mandatory, the class, from Monday to Saturday morning. Okay, it's very competitive. We have to study a lot. We have exam with all the subjects involved in the courses. Okay, so. Okay, now I saw another question. No other questions. So
also talking, sorry, about also suites we have in Polimoda. We had many, many Swedish students in the years, especially, I don't know why, but especially on fashion brand management. It's a very popular program that among Swedish students. And they're very good in it, to be honest. But if you want, we can also connect you to Swedish students if you want to get in touch with them and maybe have a chat with them, Swedish students or alumni, and including many, many students have a role through studying that is our only partner in Sweden for admission and enrollment procedures. So. They also have contacts of Swedish students that enroll to Polimoda through them. But if you want to talk with some students, we will ask, of course, their authorization for privacy reason. But I think they will be very happy to chat with you about what they do here or what they have done here and what they're doing now.
Yeah. Okay, what else? No questions. Emma, Elias, Ingrid, Tove. Are you okay? Oyub, I hope to pronounce your name in the correct way, but maybe not.
Ube? Ube, maybe?
Ube Molin, maybe. I don't know. I'm not sure. Anyway.
Okay. So I think you don't have more questions, you have anyway, so our friends at Studying are always able to answer many, many questions about the school itself. If you have more question about the fashion industry and the jobs, the job profiles, take advantage of having Nicolo here. So which program could lead you to which job, or what is your dream job? You can ask that right now. Otherwise, you will also have, during the open day, you will have also the possibility to have one-to-one sessions with faculty members. So take advantage of this also, it's very interesting. Okay?
Okay.
Elizabeth, did you become an expert as well in fashion jobs now?
Absolutely, I know everything now.
Great.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much to both of you for taking the time to be with us tonight. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And if none of the participating students have any questions, I'd just like to say thank you to you and wish you a good night.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Have a good night. Have a good evening. And we stay in touch. Thank you for everything.
Bye, everybody. Bye. Thank you for being with us.
Ciao, ciao. Ciao.
Så toppen, då tackar vi Polimoda för det och hoppas att ni tyckte det var spännande att höra på dem. Har ni några som helst funderingar kring Polimoda, utbildningarna och hur det är att plugga i Italien, så får ni jättegärna höra av er. Det finns mycket information på vår hemsida www.studin.se. Och som sagt, vi finns här för att hjälpa er svara på alla frågor som ni kan komma på utöver det som står där, och även hjälpa er genom hela ansökningsprocessen.